ISUPK.
Hey, Slum, man. It's Priest Kevin Gondonhall with the ISUPK. And the Commander Junior Allen in California, man. To all blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians. Subscribe to this channel, man. You want true salvation? You're going to learn from the priests and prophets of the ISUPK, man. Subscribe to that channel. Hit that button, man. And it's there with that. Slum.
We want no cowards in our camp, in our camp.
Slimy bastard pastors, man. These Christian pastors have led us astray, man. Give me Isaiah 9 and 16. These Christian pastors are the reason why a police officer thinks he can murder us and he knows he can be scot-free. You know that's the case, right? You know every white police officer knows I can murder a black person and I'll probably get administrative leave, you know, go hide out for a minute, let everything die down. They're probably going to riot for about 2 weeks. Right, I'll be a hero, man. They just brought out, in LA, they have a gang within the LAPD. Now this is not new. Thank the Most High for social media and cameras on the cell phones. Because what we're finding out now on social media and through the information is what black people have always known living in this hell in America. And that is the police officers are nothing more than gangs. There are literal gangs within the LAPD and other police forces across America. And guess what their gang's target is to do? To murder black people. They take a tally in a point system for how many black people you murder. Now you think about that the next time you go to call the police, black woman. The next time you go to call the police on your man because you're mad at him. The next time you go to call the police just for a welfare check. The police are not equipped to fix black people's problems. The same way these politicians are not equipped to fix black people's problems. You know the police get their power from the politicians. You understand? Neither one of them are equipped to fix our problems, but we follow them because we listen to these Christian pastors. These slimy bastard pastors have deceived black people. And because we follow Christianity, because we go to church every Sunday, and do what pastor says, the black community is destroyed. The Bible says so. Read that.
The book of Isaiah, chapter 9, verse 16. For the leaders of this people caused them to err.
The Bible says, for the leaders of blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans caused us to err. What does that mean? Meaning the people that we listen to, the people that we follow, and think that we get close to God, those are the reason why there's black on black crime. The Christian church and the Christian pastors are the reason why 350,000 black babies are aborted every year. The Christian church is the reason why black men sell drugs to pregnant black women. The Christian church is the reason why a black woman thinks she has to go and strip to make it, man. Because Christianity teaches black people to do everything against the Bible. They don't teach the truth according to this Bible. You know, something as small as don't eat pork. Don't sleep with white women. Don't get high. Don't smoke. The Christian church doesn't teach you not to do those things. The Bible says not to do those things, which should tell you this. The Christian church and the Bible are two separate entities. They are not the same. Christianity has nothing to do with the Bible. Christianity is of Satan, and those churches are the houses of Satan, man. Read that.
And they that are led of them are destroyed.
And what?
And they that are led of them are destroyed.
And they that are led of them are destroyed. Everybody want to talk about whenever black people get together, it's always something going wrong. Something always going down. Why is that? Because these filthy, money-hungry, lustful bastards, these snakes in these churches, have destroyed the black community. The civil rights movement has failed the black community. When we going to admit that, man? When we going to stop riding on that goddamn dream? It has failed. It has failed. The brother just brought out earlier, D.C. used to be Chocolate City. D.C. used to be the one city in America where niggas know they could come here and see black people all around. Everywhere, every corner, U Street. Now look at D.C. Uptown, downtown. They fired the black police officer, man. You know why? Because we follow the civil rights movement and those Christian leaders, and they told us that we gotta join hand in hand. We gotta love, brother, we gotta forgive. Well, you tell the Jewish man to forget what happened to him against the Nazis. You tell the Jewish man to forgive the Nazis for the Holocaust. You tell America to forgive the Arabs for 9/11. But guess what? You wouldn't do that because you know that's insensitive. You know that's merciless to tell a people that suffered such atrocities to forget it and forgive their abuser. Well, why is it that black people bring up what happens to them and we always told to forgive and forget? The Christian pastors have led us astray, man. We are destroyed because we follow these Christian pastors. Our leaders fail us, man. You go into church still, you should look at your pastor and know he is a pimp. If you go to church, let me tell you something right now, and I'm gonna tell you out of love because it's the truth and we tell our people the truth. If you go to church, you are a whore. Your pastor is pimping you out, man. Right. I'm sorry to say it. Listen, I was a whore too. I was in that church being hustled too. Hustling all my mama money. We can't even get McDonald's on the way home because he got all the tithes money. Hustling us, man. If you go to church, you are being pimped out. Pimped. The same way Donald Trump is pimping us out. The same way Joe Biden is going to pimp us out. Don't think any white man is going to change our conditions in America, man. That is so silly, man. Right. It's not their problem. And furthermore, why would America fix black people's problems when America runs on black people having problems? America thrives off of the destruction of black people. Why would they fix it? That's bad for business. That's not in their best interest, man. Why would America stop black people from murdering each other when they make millions of dollars in the funeral home business? Do you know the funeral home business is a billion-dollar industry in America? Who making them rich? The t-shirt industry is a billion-dollar industry. Who making them rich? Whenever black people get murdered, what we gonna do? I'm gonna put my dead homie on the t-shirt. Rest in peace, Tay. You know what I'm saying? Rise again, little Pookie. You know what I'm saying? And that's against the Lord. You understand? But that is all how America benefits from our destruction. America benefits from everything that we suffer from. That's why they continue to oppress us and destroy us. Because the moment that our community starts to actually change for the better, that will be the decline of America. You can't have two empires thriving at one time. Go look throughout history. One empire had to fall. If it was two at one time, one failed because it only could be one empire at a time. Guess what? In order for black people to be established as a nation, America has to fall. And for America to fall, we cannot think that some white man is gonna fix our conditions. Whether it's Joe Biden, whether it's Donald Trump, they all the same, man. They all the same, they're both devils. Give me Psalms 55 and 20, man. They're both devils. Kamala, the water. Kamala Harris, black women are going to vote for Joe Biden, a known pedophile, because Kamala Harris is his vice president running mate. Kamala Harris is not even a black woman. Let me tell y'all something, man. I know it's hard to understand because we don't learn the truth according to the Bible. Kamala Harris is not even a sister, man. Her father is a dang old white man because his father was a white man. Kamala Harris is a white woman in blackface. And you can tell. Look at Kamala Harris' track record in California. Look how many black people Kamala Harris locked up. On false charges. You understand? Look how many people Joe Biden locked up. You should tell us something, black man. Don't go vote. There's no such thing as the lesser of two evils. If somebody came to you and said, listen, I'm robbing you. Give me your wallet. Now, you want me to stab you or you want me to shoot you? You're going to be like, well, what kind of options is that? Would you pick one? Right. Well, when you going to stab me? When you going to shoot me? It make no sense. Right. Look, the brother said, hey, you, listen, I'm not choosing. You can have it. That's what black people got to do. We cannot choose which way we want to be destroyed. You understand? We should not participate in America's games. The political system, all that is games of snakes. You understand? It's a game for snakes, and black people are the mice. We are the ones that are destroyed and devoured in this place. You understand? The political system in America never benefited America, never benefited black people, and it never will. Let me tell you something about America and its politicians and the white man. The Bible describes them perfectly. Read that.
The book of Psalms, chapter 55, verse 20. He hath put forth his hands against such as be at peace with him.
The Bible says he hath put forth his hands with such that be at peace with him, man. Read it again, the why.
Verse 20. He hath put forth his hands against such as be at peace with him.
This is describing America. Black people, you ever ask yourself, what have we done to white people for them to hate us so much? You ever ask yourself, what have we really done to America and white people for them to hate us the way they do? Black people, we know we murder each other. Everything that we do as black people, we do it to each other. Black people don't murder white people the way they murder us. Black people don't go out and just hate white people the way they hate us. Black people have done nothing but serve America. We've done nothing but love America, serving all them wars, fight and sacrifice for America. Hispanics and Native Americans. Right now, in California, you got Hispanic workers picking fruit whilst a wildfire going on. You know why? Because blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans are the reason why America was ever great in the first place, man. America needs us. We never needed them, man. And it's so wicked for them to make us believe that we really need them to survive. You know what we need from you, Mr. White Man? You know what we need from you, America? For you to let us be. For you to leave us alone with no interference and just watch how we'll prosper. We see what happened in Black Wall Street in Tulsa, Oklahoma. In the 1920s, black people established a financial mecca. Black people, without the help of white people or the government. This is, now keep in mind, this is black people now. We're coming right out of slavery with nothing. And we established some of the greatest cities all over the earth. All over this nation, man. And guess what happened? White people came and burned it down. They came and destroyed it. Let's tell you something, black man. We should look at the history and see how to go forward. We didn't need them to establish Black Wall Street. You know what we needed to survive? We needed them to leave us the hell alone. We needed them to not be such devils like they are.
I'm not letting nobody tell you cry. You know why? Because I never saw you before. But you are black man like me. Nobody tell you cry. You know why? Because I never saw you before. But you are black man like me. And it's workshop.
My whole life was trying to find something to follow. Had loyalty, every man tried to borrow. Felt pain. And a lot of sorrow, got betrayed, so packed, I didn't even have my heart broke. Living confused, about to lose hope. Cops got me on the side of the road, like a sideshow. Need an antidote before I croak. Now I'm setting fire to rhythm and blues, call this guitar smoke. Rebel with no cause, trying to find direction. The world got me vexed. Picked up a bad liquor habit that's hereditary from oppression. Felt like my life was on fire, trying to find an exit. Now look, 10 G's plus a good record. Sometimes a follower is a soldier, trying to find a good shepherd. Plus when you in hell, how do you excel? Wisdom, the breath of life, I believe in fairy tale. Listen well to what I tell. No calling can cause pain, something that a rebel knows very well. Can't you tell I was sent from the Lord? Got a tongue like a two-edged sword. With